The other major lake of the region is Somoriri, which is 23 kilometers long and 7 to 8 kilometers wide. Situated at an altitude of nearly 15,000 feet, this lake of crystal clear water, towered over by snow-capped peaks, is the breeding ground of the bar-headed geese. A variety of other birds also visit the lake every summer and enliven the wilderness with their songs. Yet another lake of the region is known as Sokar, which occupies the center of an extensive salt-covered plain in the Roopshaw Highland. The swampy area around the lake is the summer habitat of a large number of birds. Changthang is also home to a variety of wildlife. Among these, the most commonly seen animal is the kyang, or the Tibetan wild ass. Herds of these sleek animals bring life to the desolate vastness of the region. The most dominant inhabitants of Changthang, however, are the Changpa, the nomadic people who roam the western Tibetan tableland in splendid isolation. They live off their flocks of sheep, goats, and yaks. Among their prized possession are the pashmina-bearing goats called Changra. This golden fiber, which covers the rich and the famous around the world, constitutes the backbone of Changpa sustenance. The Changpas are mostly on the move. They live in huge circular tents of yak wool known as rebo, which is used by the entire family for living, as well as storage for food stocks. At the end of the grazing season at one place, the camp is shifted. While the herd moves to the new destination, the camp equipment is loaded on yaks. Large caravans are generally seen trudging along the banks of the lakes in search of new pastures. Indeed, the life of the Changpa is dictated by the welfare of the herds. This then is a brief account of the virgin areas of Ladakh. One has to actually visit these areas to appreciate their uniqueness. Ladakh by itself evokes intense feelings among the visitors. The new areas are sure to leave everyone spellbound.